And tonight, more questions and answers for communities affected by forever chemicals during the pandemic. Good evening and thanks for joining us. I'm Clay Gordon.
And I'm Amanda Hill. Pat and Cindy are off tonight. You've heard the devastating stories about PFAS before. It's a class of chemicals linked to serious health problems.
But it gets worse. Now forever chemicals could prevent some people from making the antibodies needed after getting the COVID-19 vaccine. News 7's Vivian Lee explains.
There are over 9,000 of these chemicals.
On a national call with reporters, toxicologists who monitor PFAS chemicals say high levels of exposure could undermine COVID-19 vaccines rolling out across Maine and the country.
From everything that we know about these chemicals, we know that they do suppress the immune system.
Dr. Linda Birnbaum is a retired director of the National Institute for Environmental Health Sciences. The compounds used for decades are in many household products, including furniture, carpet, and food packaging. Linked to organ cancers and reproductive problems, the chemicals may also limit the immune system's ability to make virus-fighting antibodies after getting a shot. This fall, nearly two dozen homeowners in the town of Fairfield were advised to use bottled water after tests revealed very high amounts of the compounds. The possible source of the contamination, biosolids used as fertilizer on farmland for decades. Dr. Birnbaum says the vaccine's two-shot protocol may not be enough protection for people living in contaminated areas.
But instead of getting that one booster that's now required with the two mRNA vaccines, that maybe you would need a third booster.
Now, the CDC's Agency for Toxic Substances and Disease Registry is studying the intersection between PFAS and the virus to see if exposure reduces vaccine protection. And that research is expected to be included in federal health investigations going on in eight different states across the country.
It's a big worry for Andrea Amico, whose husband and two young children, including her daughter Sophia, drank water laced with PFAS at the Pease Trade Port. Federal health officials are currently registering adults and children exposed to PFAS at the former base for a health study. But it was too late in the process to include the Pease community.
You know, as we all sit here and wait patiently for a COVID-19 vaccine that's going to help us in this pandemic, people that have been impacted by PFAS exposure wonder, will the vaccine be effective for them?
Environmental activists and scientists in the meantime are urging the public to get vaccinated against COVID-19, especially people with PFAS exposure, to give their immune systems another weapon to fight the virus. Vivian Lee, News Center, Maine.
Health officials say tests can determine whether antibody levels are adequate following two doses of the vaccine. If those levels are low, a third booster could be necessary.